had his own seat. I'm going to ask
but I thank God because God is always strengthening us as children of God. And what I remembered, how could the news for a good Simo resilient? Then I remember the script in the book of Acts chapter 10 verse 4 when the angel of God visited Cornelius and it said to Cornelius, your prayer and your gifts to the poor have come up as a memorial offering unto God. Now, Brasimo, as Narimutio Bazalani, has been one of those people helping us here in our church with, you know, a few things. And I really thank God, you know, one of the members of ILC of last time when Outlaw the News came, Brasimo, into this time, matter the sheet, I said, oh wow, it's really true. And there was a very Indonesian style. And I give all the old students, you know, the only thing I can get done is to say a tribute to Ntate Dube. You know, Haki Nahana Kirisho, a great tree has fallen and a great gentleman has fallen asleep. But still we have God's promises. Indeed, it broke our hearts, you know, to see a gentleman like him. But I've written a poem, Bazalani. This poem is written in Setswana. That's what I said to him. I'm going to say this poem in Setswana because Rona, in our culture, when a great man, a great leader has fallen, we do maboko, meaning worry. We acknowledge that guy, the person who has fallen asleep. But the Bokola guy already badahan. But in English, what I'm saying is it is very sad, and indeed it's very sad. Our hearts are bleeding and it's very painful. Now Kibua Katamaha Bitsi Tuludianaha. Lifa Pilotaruna di Utwile Musuku. Arisile Kadipilu Tedi di Batabata. Morena Uboni Hole Matswanidi. Rene Risa Renka Sikara Hana Bulwetsi Ruri Usitlo Kana Utere Mohaitu Ruri Utsuko Hulachehel Pilota Runa Dirota Mahdi Fela Rita Dia Rene Banna Libasani Pilota Runa Diruhile Kawaitu Atamaile Kaene in a little yalela. Kana Hutata Bahai Tsuko Amohela. Merita Amohela. Iri Rubala Nakahiso Tuludia de Kaf. Rubala Nakahiso Pizzi Tamaha. Rubala Nakahiso Pizzi Tuludi. Homotaham Bahai Tsu. Iri Homotaham Dialebuch.
We are here to bid farewell to a gentle giant. When we were listening to speakers that were speaking yesterday about Ubaba Dube, we learned that he was everything to many people. He was different things to many people. Others, they explained with him. He was a man of great humility. He fought his fight till the end. He was a man who loved God dearly. As I said, he was a member of this branch. He would come here early, probably earlier than any other people, and he would sit right over there just before the beginning of the proceedings of the day. He was a man who was known for his cleanliness and his neatness. I'm sure we can all attest that he was all that. Amen. And also, I would like to say, much as we know there is nothing beautiful about death, but as people who are here to comfort the family and all those who are close to him, may we also embrace the joyous mood, because we are celebrating a life that has been well lived. We know that he fought his fight till the end. And we know that right now he is resting in the arms of Jesus Christ. I'm gonna ask a friend from IBM, where he used to work, to come, Usis Pam, to come and give her words of comfort. Amen.
I would like to greet you all in equal standing. My name is Pamela Ohasiabela, a friend to Sai and an ex-colleague from IBM. Standing here, I'm standing for myself. I'm standing for Moshibudi Mahlo. I'm standing for Virginia Rasiekela. I am standing for Dudu Sibui, as we are all friends. I was introduced to Simon in 2012 when I joined IBM by Johnny Gounder. Sai was doing an internal audit for the previous company I used to work for, as we were acquired by IBM. I remember the first time he saw me. We spoke and he couldn't hold himself, and he said, "I don't understand why you're in the administration field." I looked at him and said, "What do you mean?" He said, "No, man, you need to be in marketing. You need to be in the media space." And every time he came to my desk, it was a constant reminder, "Manje Pam, we are in the marketing." And he would laugh about it. He was always motivated us. He always preached about believing in ourselves. He always told us, "Black child, it is possible." One of the speakers in his memorial mentioned that if wisdom was a person, that was Simon. Indeed. I can vividly remember when I told him I will be joining the IBM marketing team. He was very ecstatic. He couldn't stop talking about it. He said, "You see now we are channeling into the right path." Love for denim jeans was remarkable. He will even go further in informing you about the threads and stitches, and he would then tell you about the designer. The love he had for his garden, that was his happy place. He loved flowers, and he would educate. Sigh, you have always wished us success and good in life. You encourage us to buy properties, and you'll take care of our garden. I'm deeply shattered as your wish was granted, but you never got a chance to see the house. Sigh, you always encourage us to do best, and best in everything. Sigh, was never afraid of anything. In any situation, he always had a solution. The word can't never existed in his vocab. Sai was a go-to person if you needed information or wanted to buy something. Sai was a big giver. He gave without expecting anything in return. His cleanliness was next to godliness. Sai would have arguments with the kitchen cleaners, and they would complain to Shibu and Dudu and I. Sitran kunme nungangwe. And would, okay, Sai, what do you want in the kitchen? And he always say, Marapem would go this each. And a vegan fight to win that. Like, but when I was sissy, about 9, I say, yeah, I'll show them how to do their job. I have so much to share about Sai. His love for his wife and family was incomparable. A day will never go by without mentioning his wife, Sis June. I would like to comfort the family from the book of Isaiah 41, verse 13. Death may have taken Sai from us, but it will never take away the memories. Whenever we had disagreements, Sai always said, you only live once, because tomorrow is never guaranteed. Sai wanted to know how you spent your weekends. Believe me, it will end in arguments, because Shibu and Dudu and Sai would be arguing. And he would say, me being me, I'll have to listen to all three. And in conclusion, Sai would say, Mina Pem, if God remembers me today, I would gladly respond with a smile, because I have lived the best life I wanted. I have served God each day of my life. I have loved unconditionally, and I have fulfilled my purpose. Last time I saw Sai, I was laying my father to rest in bed. Last time I spoke to Sai, it was 2 weeks ago, when I was informing him about Shibu's that's
That you could easily share that or allow him to share that with us, because you knew exactly where you stand with him. The other thing I also wanted to just mention is that we all speak of the influence that he had in our lives. You're taking it a bit further. But it would be sad that whatever he impacted on all of us, for us not to continue with that, to continue with his legacy, in order for us to impart it to somebody else or the next person that comes in our lives. Today, or this month, is celebrated Women's Day. And as Simo impacted from a man, I wish to take it upon all women here to also impact that. And you've spoken so nicely about him, you know. And we do that as well. You know, as women, encourage each other, you know, put each other on a pedestal and not wait for men necessarily to do that for us. I just wanted to thank everybody and Julian, who keeps being me, Simo, and Claire. I am continuously keeping you guys in. And I just wanted to also convey some of from your expertise at Imperial Aid Services.
Amen. Thank you so much, Ashla, for beautiful words. I'd like to acknowledge the presence of our leader, church leader, Mark Bishop, we welcome you. And we are grateful that you are able to make it. Amen. At this point in time, I'm going to ask Mukhosi, who is Shakeshe, to come up front and use your 3 minutes effectively. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor. Good morning, Bazalwane. My name is Shakeshe Mukhosi. I'm honored to say a few words about Papa Simo, or Pra Simo, as I used to call him, and he would always say to me, "Hey, Tam Shege Shege, Grand Shege Shege, Hey, Wapere Grand Jankajeno." You know, that's how we created each other. Papa Simo was a father figure. I came into the family as Brunette's friend, and he became a father to me. Papa Simo was the most orderly man, actually, I knew in his ways and how he led his life. He loved order. He would put us back in line with my sister and friend Brunette and he did this in the most loving way. You actually looked forward to straightening up your life after that chat. I will always cherish his wisdom and the kind of things that we spoke about. When he pulled you into his life, you never left. He cared so much whether you were in sight or not. He cared about my well-being, and would check on how I was, whether I was next to him or not near to him. There's never been a conversation, if I think about it, in this COVID-19 pandemic period, where every conversation I've had with Mama or Brunette, that they would not say Papa Simo R or Shapuna. Oh, he had the most impeccable dress sense. All of you know that. He always was well turned out. He loved cleanliness, cleanest man alive. Mama Gina reminded me the other day about how he always thoroughly cleaned his shoes before storing them. So when you actually looked at his wardrobe, you thought like you were in a shoe shop or men's clothing shop. That's how clean he was. And oh, someone else said he loved his jeans, my jean giant. More than anything else, he loved his family a lot, in acts and in words. If you'd spend time with him and Mama Gina, you'd notice how much he adored Mama Gina. Mama Gina, my heart felt comforting words to you, Kaholo. I would like to thank Papa Simo for being a great father figure to me, for his wisdom, for his kindness, love, and for accepting me as one of his own. I surely will continue on the attributes he instilled in me, attributes of being orderly, of always looking good and presentable, and all, most of all, of loving unconditionally. To Mama Gina, Mbembe, Bri, and family, all I say is that Papa Simo ran his amazing race and left us with beautiful memories. May we carry all the good experiences with us and find comfort in the Lord our God. As I conclude, always remember Psalm 46:1 that says, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Amen. That was a beautiful expression of how you remember Ntate Dube. Next, I'm going to ask the HOD of the counseling department, Mr. Mike Mdluli, to come to the fore. Amen.
I greet you all in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior, King Jesus. Thank you very much, pastors. Thank you, my bishop, for offering such an opportunity to know a man of this caliber. Yesterday, as I was preparing for today, shining my shoes, I remembered a day I met Babu Simo at church. My shoes were so dirty because I used to live in Fort Lauderdale, coming with taxis, and he went on me. How can you, as a man, walk with such dirty shoes? And that, I started to realize, what a man is this? How can he? But going forth, understanding who he is, I realized that he was a man. To him, you either do it or you don't. There was no gray area in between. The legacy that he lived is despicable. It is, you can't explain who he is, because there's not words that can explain what he stands for, his character, what he stands for. He was very firm in everything he does. He joined the counseling department in 2008, and he had to leave because of ill. He fell ill in 2014, but for who he was, the time that we spent with him, it was, yes, there's no words that I can explain who he was. But I just want to say to the family, The legacy that he left with all of us, when I remember everything that he stood for, I want to hold on to that. I'm asking the family, let that not pass. Let that legacy live on. Since you, my sister, please make sure that what he stood for doesn't die. His footsteps, the footprint that he left, that footprint, make sure that you always dust it off, that somebody else must see it. The young people that comes behind us may see who he was and what he stands for. Know this, that only Holy Spirit will guide you. Only Holy Spirit will give you the strength, the sustenance for you to be able to fulfill what he stood for to the end. And the word of God tells us that God is closer to those who mourn. Just know that he's close to you. He won't leave you, nor will you forsake you. There is nothing that can apart you from God. He's by your side. Hold on to him. Your eyes on him. Amen.
I want to hold on to everything that he stood for. That's what Ntate Mdluli said. And he's asking Mom Junior to preserve all that he stood for the future generations to learn from that. That was powerful. Amen. Next, I'm going to ask the CEO of IBM to kindly step forward, and that is Mr. Hamilton Rasefola.
Greetings to all the saints. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, amen. I also want to greet my bishop, the pastors who are here, and distinguished guests, and a special greeting to the Dube family, Sis Junior, and the children, and the family at large. I am here representing IBM, and I've known Simo for a while. I rejoined IBM in 2013. Simo has been there for 18 years. He served IBM for 18.5 years. He was a diligent worker, dedicated, hardworking, a consistent high performer. In IBM, they really drive excellence and performance. And if you don't perform, they walk you out. So for him to survive 18.5 years means he was very good in his work. Simo reminds me of Colossians 3:17, that whatever you do, do it as if you do for the Lord. There is a level of excellence in what he did. He loved his work, excelling it. And for me, I find that people who do what he does excel and find great success in their lives. That you don't work for your boss, you don't work for the company, you work for the Lord. Therefore, you don't care how they treat you, you deliver because the Lord is watching you over the talent gift has given you. So Simo was like that. Because Simo genuinely loved people, he was popular, a people's person, well-loved, and provided great support for his colleagues, a true pillar of strength to many of his colleagues and friends. Simon was a highly competent business controller at IBM, a job that took him to many places and countries, and overall auditing IBM business process across. Simon retired from IBM, responsible for the integrity of IBM business processes, a job he did very well and excel in it. He retired from IBM in 2017, after 18.5 years, a great innings. He kept many of his leaders out of trouble. So all his leaders, Johnny Gowden, many leaders at IBM, who he makes sure they did things in the right order and with ethically. They loved him a lot because he kept them out of trouble. So respected by many leaders he served, loved by many he worked with, and honored by many of his colleagues. Simon was a blessing, a truly good man. We at IBM truly appreciate his blazing light that came into IBM. Today the light has dimmed, and we pay our respect to our esteemed colleague and friend. We say, rest in peace, friend. You have run your race. You kept the faith. You lived by example. You finished the race. Rest in peace, my friend. To Sis Junior and the children, thank you for sharing Simon with us at IBM for many years. May the good God Almighty give you and your family comfort. May his memories and his good works and loving people be a reminder of a life well lived. I leave you with Psalm 34, verse 18, which says, the Lord is near to the heartbroken, and he saved those who are crushed in spirit. But most importantly, to everybody here, this fellow, Simon, took this verse, 11:28. Come to me, all who are heavy and who are weary and heavily burdened, and I will give you rest. The God we serve in the world of uncertainty today, if you come to him, if you have challenges, he will give you rest. Simon chose his path many years ago, and he found peace. And I'm sure today his soul is in the right place. Be comforted. Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you so much, Ndate Hamilton. I was worried when you came up because I know you are a speaker. I thought you were going to take two times your time allocated to you. Thank you so much. At this time, I'm going to ask the daughter, Batabile, to come to the front and say a word or two about her father. Amen.
Daddy, the shining light of my life, I came to know you as a phenomenal leader, a man who could command the room, a positive influencer, a man of exceptional character and excellence. I came to know you as my daddy. It was you who bought me my first bicycle and taught me how to ride it. I remember falling off a few times, but I also remember your voice of encouragement saying, get back on there, Tabile. What a celebration it was when I finally rode down that road on my own. In you, I had the greatest supporter. In you, I learned that no matter what, you keep going. It was also you who taught me the value of education and who invested in mine. On many of my school nights, you would call me into your bedroom and help me practice my times tables over and over until I got them right. You would stay up reading my essays, correcting the grammatical errors, and highlighting how brilliant of a writer I am. I was able to wear a graduation gown and walk across that stage because you always pushed me to strive, to work hard, and to do the very best that I can. It was you who always made sure I look and smell exceptionally well from head to toe. You would go shopping on my behalf and bring back with you expensive perfumes, dazzling dresses, and shoes that always made people ask, wow, where did you buy that? You believed in me always, and you always pushed me to exceed what I thought were my limits. You taught me many lessons about discipline, cleanliness, humility, resilience, and dedication. Today I am strong. Today I am independent. Today I am humble. Today I know how to push through and work my way through anything because that's what you taught me. If I could, I would walk the daddy and daughter journey with you 1,000 times over, but I'd probably be more attentive of time. I am humbled to have had you as my dad, and I find solace in that you lived your life and it was full. Your cup overflowed and the waters dripped into mine. A man in his own league, a man I always looked up to, my father, my daddy. Rest in peace.
Hallelujah. What an exceptional father he was to his children. It is truly difficult and hard to forget somebody that has given you so much to remember. Our last speaker, just before we allow the preacher to come and give us the word, is the daughter, Brynette. Brynette, I'm going to ask you to come forward. Amen.
I'm going to read an eulogy on behalf of my mom to my dad. No one can ever replace the person that you are to me. I speak in the present tense because I know you are forever in my presence. I will always hold on to our memories. We prayed together every night before going to sleep. We made promises to each other every morning to watch prayer without fail. Our lives were a beautiful routine of picking our favorite songs and going to serve at Employee Food Specialist day in and day out, no matter the situation we're faced with. Through all these years when you were sick, I appointed myself as your doctor, running up and down the house, doing my best and fulfilling my duties as your partner for life. I have seen you overcome all sorts of operations and ailments. And this time around, life chose to rob me of the life of my life. Losing you has been the most excruciating and painful experience, and it will continue to be difficult to not wake up next to you and not be able to wish you a good morning. I know you will not be there physically, but your soul will always be there with me. One or the other must leave. One or the other must grieve. That is forever the way. Braving what has to be borne, widening the ache is in the heart. One howsoever adored, first must be summarized away. That is the will of the Lord. One or the other must stay. You are gone too soon. My partner, my confidant, my honey, my best friend. I promise to love you until the very end. You are out of my sight, but you will forever remain in my heart. Not even your death will keep us apart. I know you are with me right now as I continue with my life. I know you still watch over me, and I know you will remain, I will remain your loving partner. Although you can't be with me, we are truly not apart until the day I take the final breath of life. You will forever be living in my heart. I wish I knew that it was time for you to leave. You were in and out of hospitals so many times, but I knew that you will always come back home. On that unfaithful Sunday, August the 9th, at the hospital, I cried out to the Lord for mercy and his grace. When I saw the doctors resuscitating you back to life, I knew that your time to serve in heaven has arrived and that you are no longer given an opportunity to serve on earth. I wish I could see you, hear you, feel you, smell you, and touch you one more time, because walking into our home without experiences these five senses won't make any sense anymore. I know that I will hear your voice no more. I will continue to lean on and trust in the Almighty for strength and comfort, but God knows best. I miss you already, but I know you are in a place where you can't feel the pain you felt on Sunday the 9th. My love, for you will never fade. I love you and always will. There is a season for everything and a reason for everything. Time will heal, but neither time nor reason won't change the way I feel, for no one knows the heartache that lies behind my smile. Your memory is a keepsake for which I will never part. God has you in his arms. I have you in my heart. My heart hurts every minute I think about you. 26 years of memories of this union cannot just disappear in a week, a month, or a year. I will forever miss you and love you. I release you to the heavens above. In Isaiah 41, verse 10, it says, "Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. May your soul rest in peace." Sorry, I know that I only have 3 minutes, but I mean, Abuti Simo is, was, and will always be my dad. And I listened to the memorial service yesterday and today, all the speakers and everybody, every single thing that they've said about him has just been the perfect person that he is and will always be. And I will always love him. I mean, Abuti Simo is always, he's my stepdad, but he's never, not even a single day, made me feel that way. I am the person that I am today because of him. He's a very strong person, and I know that wherever he is, he's actually smiling down on us. Whenever I think of Psalm 23, a Psalm of David, which most of you know, but it says, "The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil. Through the darkest valley, I will feel no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepared a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." And these are the words that I just hear with Simo saying right now as we release him into the other world. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you so much, Brunette, and thank you so much, Mom Junior, for such a beautiful eulogy. We have come to the time for the word, and I'm going to ask Pastor Tami Mutobi to come to the front and give us a word. If we can just encourage him and accept him as he comes. Amen.
Amen. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, you said in your word, "Man shall not live by bread alone, but by each and every word that comes out of the mouth of God." Even now, O God, at the time where our hearts are troubled, at the time where our hearts are broken, we pray that your word, as it comes forth, that it may comfort your people, O God. For God, you said we must comfort your people, O God. And I pray that, mighty God, that your word will go out like a seed that will be planted in each and everyone's heart, that it will germinate, O God. We thank you and we bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Greetings to family. Greetings to friends, colleagues, and also greetings to our leader, my bishop, and also greetings to our pastors. With the few minutes that I have, first of all, I would like to say to the family, Sis Junior and the family, you know, I know in times like this, we feel as if God is far. But again, I'll quote the verse that Abraham Hamilton quoted, Psalms 34, that the Lord is closer to the brokenhearted. If there's anyone that God is closer to at this time, it is you and your family. I know it is a time where we are living in days of COVID, where we speak of social distance, but God doesn't know social distancing. He's closer with you. He is with you. And what I like about our God, if you read the latter end of that verse, he's not only with you, he says he saves the crushed in spirit. God will save you. He will carry you, all of us. He will carry us in this difficult time. And indeed, this too shall pass. Amen. What a man, what a life we are celebrating today. I think, I don't know about you, but I'm challenged. Actually, from yesterday, as I was watching the memorial service, I was really challenged. I was like, what a life. You know, in life, there's people who pass on, and everybody nje kuyadlula, you know. But there's people when they pass on, like Oprah Simo, you know, you can see what it's just, and it is up to all of us, when we pass on, what legacy are we building? I've heard he was a husband, a father, a mentor, a leader, a servant of God, a prayer warrior. I mean, I heard he also started a prayer group at church, at work. He was a prayer warrior. There's a lot that we can learn from this life. The question is, he has done his part. He has lived his life like he knew Oguti, his time is short. That is why he was able to build, to teach, to mentor, to give out everything that he had, because he knew his time was short. And a man like this, the only thing that we could do, it is for us to uphold his value, his memories, his legacy, and also walk in his footpath and make him proud, that when he looks at the balconies of heaven, he will be proud of us, and he will say, "Ngidlalile yami indima." You know, there's people who live as if they are living forever. Hey, asiphili forever. We are not living forever. One day, yes, today it is Prasimo. One day it will be you. But the question is, when you are lying here, are we going to be talking this way about you? Every day when we live, we are writing a story. We are writing a book. What a testimony here. I think Brasimo's life was a testimony. Amen. And the question is, what about you? And quickly, I'm going to read 1 Corinthians just for us to understand what is death. When we read in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 26, it says, the last enemy to be destroyed is death. Death is our enemy. Death is not our friend. You know, I hear sometimes people say, you know, you can't compare death with that. We sing, we celebrate. But when death is here, there's no celebration. Because death is an enemy. And an enemy is something that seeks to harm us. An enemy is something that wants to destroy us. An enemy is something that brings destructions in our life. And when we read in John chapter 10, verse 10, it says, a thief only comes to steal, kill, and destroy. That's what death does in our lives. It steals the joy. It kills us inside. And eventually destroys us. Because it's an enemy. Jack Tombs once said, those we love truly never leave us. There are things that death cannot touch. Now, this enemy, how do we conquer it as I close? We can conquer this enemy. We can conquer this enemy. How do we conquer this enemy? If we read the same verse, John 10, verse 10, now we know that the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus Christ tells us, But he came that we may have life, and life to its abundance. You know, those people, they think ukuthi bayaphila kanti abaphili. Kunabantu, you know, abaphili bafile bahamba because they don't have Jesus Christ. If you don't have Jesus Christ, you have no life, because he's the life. If you don't have Jesus Christ, you don't have the life. And Jesus Christ says to Mary in John 11, verse 25, to Martha, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die. And whoever lives by believing in me will never die. Do you believe this? So this tells us that the only way for us to conquer the enemy, the death, it is by us accepting Jesus Christ. It's by us having Jesus Christ in our lives. And John 3 verse 16 tells us that for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. I heard Prasimo was not afraid of death because he knew he's got life. He knows for him to die is to gain. But people are afraid to die because bayazi abakabi ready. Bayazi ukuthi they haven't sorted things. They haven't done the right thing. But as Naskat, let's do the right thing. And there's no better time than now. The only way we can have life, it is by us giving our lives to Jesus Christ. And as I close, Charles H. Spurgeon says, when the time comes for you to die, you need not to be afraid, because death cannot separate us from the love of God. Let's bow our head. You might be here, and as I'm speaking, I'm talking about Jesus Christ being the one that gives us life. And you are saying, my brother, Mfundisi, I've heard even yesterday on the memorial service, they spoke that Tuprasimo was born again, that he lived for Christ. Even now, I don't know if I will die now, what will happen to me. If you have that question, I'm not going to embarrass you. I'm not going to ask you to raise your hand, but I'm going to ask you to do this prayer. And this prayer is between you and God. I'm going to ask you, everyone, and if you know yourself that you haven't accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, please make this prayer personal. It is a simple prayer. It is a prayer whereby you confess with your mouth and you believe with your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I confess with my mouth and believe with my heart that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. He came into this world to save me. Jesus Christ, come into my heart. Rule and reign in my life. From today, you are my Lord and my Savior. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you. We thank you for this service where we are celebrating the life of our dear brother. We also thank you for the souls, mighty God, that mighty God, God, mighty Lord, to be introduced to heavens, O God. Lord, we pray that your power, your spirit, mighty God, will be with them, that you'll protect them, that you'll meet every need that they have, O God. We thank you, O Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.
Thank you so much to Murutim Tobi. We really appreciate the word that you have shared. Indeed, the last enemy to be conquered is death. And we do that by accepting Jesus Christ as the Lord and our Savior, because he is life and life eternal. Amen. Time is really against us at this moment. I am going to ask all of us, as requested by the enemy, sorry, by the family, as we have come to the conclusion of this part of the service, we are going to be moving to the West Park Cemetery, where we will be laying the remains of Untate Simo. And it also gives me pleasure to say farewell, Babu Simo. Farewell. You have fought the good fight of faith, and I'm sure you are in a better place now. You are resting in the arms of the one you have been working for, in the arms of the one you have loved so dearly. So from here, we're going to proceed into the cemetery. And just to close off this service, may I ask us to close our eyes and bow our heads. Heavenly Father, we give you praise. Siyakubonga Nkulunkulu ongcwele ukuthi usisimamisile Baba kulomsebenzi. We thank you for the power of the Holy Spirit that was present in the service. We thank you that you are not done with the work of healing. You will still continue, O God, to bind the wounds of those Nkulunkulu onamandla who are brokenhearted. We know that, Lord, you will be with them because you are a patient God. Siyabonga ke Baba, as we wrap up the service, as we move, we are moving to the cemetery, Father God. We pray, mighty God, that you travel with us, traveling mercies, as we proceed, O Nkulunkulu ongcwele, to the next phase of the service. We give you praise, we give you honor, for you alone are the only true God, the one and the true God. In Jesus' name, we thank you and we bless you. Amen. As we said, Bazalwane, we're going to follow after the coffin and we'll be driving to West Park following the hearse.
Father, bless your name.
Sala, Sala,
YouTubers, I am Benjamin Dube.
Nezimu.
This is your boy Omega.
I'm Nathaniel.
Women in Praise.
Become part of the Spirit Online community by clicking the subscribe button.
If you'd like to watch more of our videos, be sure to click one of the thumbnails over there.
And if you enjoyed the song, be sure to download it by clicking the iTunes logo
down there on this corner on the left. Thank you for spending your time with us. And remember,
we've got the Spirit.
We've got the Spirit.
We've got the Spirit.
We've got the Spirit.
Thank you, Lord. Oh, Fanana, Jesus,
Greetings, Bazalane, once again. We are doing the last leg of this service. Just before we get the coffin to come out from the car, I'm going to ask Uneo Siopela to read the obituary for us. But just before we do that, just before she comes, I'm going to ask that we close our eyes and pray. Heavenly Father, once again, we thank you. We give you praise and all the honor, for you are a good God. Even namanje nkulunkulu ongcwele, as we are doing this leg of the service, we ask you to lead and to guide us, O God. May you be at the front of everything and every word that is going to be spoken, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Neo, would you please come?
I greet you all in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Andries Simon Simo Dube was born in Snawane, Soweto on the 27th of April, 1955. He was the second son of the late Lizzy Ngoli and Thole Dube. He started his education at Simogile Lower Primary School and then went to Temboni High Primary, where he obtained his junior certificate. Simon then proceeded to Sikanontwane High School and Olande High School, respectively. He then matriculated in 1974. In 1975, he began his studies towards a Bachelor of Commerce degrees at the University of Zululand. Simo started his employment journey at Munigre after he moved to the Mint Group, which is part of the Glen Rand MIB. He proceeded to Price Ford, which is now known as Alexander Forbes. He then later was employed at IBM, where he worked until his retirement. After his retirement, he joined his partner in the family business, Empoleni Food Specialist. In 2008, he trained as a counselor of Grace Bible Church and continued until serving to 2014. However, due to his dedication to his family, work, and poor illness, it led to him taking a step back from the overall commitment. He is survived by his partner, Junior Sine, one son, three daughters, and a brother. He passed away on the 9th of August, 2020, after suffering complications due to diabetes. Isaiah 41:10 says, "So I will strengthen you and help you. I will hold you up with my righteous hand." I'd like to end off with this poem called The Broken Chain. We little knew that day God was calling to your name. In life we loved you, and in death we'll do the same. It broke our hearts to lose you. You did not go alone, for a part of us went with you. The day God called you home, you left us beautiful memories. Your love is still our guide, and although we cannot see you, you are always at our side. Our family chain is broken, and nothing seems to be the same. But God calls us one by one, and our chain will be linked again. Rest in peace, Andries Simon Dube. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I'm going to ask Brunette to come to the fore and read the flowers.
Thank you for the teaching, wisdom, and love from Shibu, Pam, Dudu, and Viji. Viji? In loving memory of Simon Dube, the Lord has chosen you to be with him, although he has taken you from us. Your memory will never escape us. You're gone but not forgotten, although you are part, but God has you in his keeping. We have you in our hearts. Now that you are gone, I guess we have to be strong. Goodbye, Simon.
Thank you so much. I'm going to hand over to the pastor.
Thank you so much. We can proceed with the coffin. Stella Baba Baba 6 will help us. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, to this service where we lay our brother to rest, we thank you, O God, that you've been with us thus far. And we pray that even in this service, Lord God, you'll continue guiding us and comforting those who need your comfort. We thank you and we bless you. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 Now, as we lay our brother to rest, we know that here, we are just laying his body, and we know that his spirit is not here. This is just his body. And when we read in 1 Corinthians, the Bible tells us that 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 20, just before we descend, it says, "But Christ has indeed been raised from the dead, the first fruit of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through a man, the resurrection of the dead also comes through Amen. We know that as we lay our dear brother in this place, that one day when the Messiah comes, sizovuswa naye, as we know, ukuthi uMessiah wethu conquered death. Thank you.
Yeah! Masungu.
Yes, Lord.
Tembe lona.
Aha.
Amasu.
Hey, Gosia.
Atembe lona. Kanjinati si. Tembe lona.
Thank you so much. Genesis chapter 3 verse 19 tells us that by the sweat of your face you shall eat bread till you return to the ground. For out of it you were taken, for you are dust, and to dust you shall return. So cela bazosiza with umhlabathi and I'll call everyone on a long elo long ngwaba to come. And as they come, I'll also read Genesis chapter 3, verse 19. It by the sweat of your brow, you will eat your food until you return to the ground. Since from it you were taken, for dust you are, and dust you will return. I don't know from the family if you would also like to come. At this time, we'll give you an opportunity for you to bid your last farewell to your loved one.
Jesu figa kuseni sebenzi baka.
ufike kuseni sebethi maqedile ngawe ebusuku afike kuseni ezokupha amandla amasha.
Yes, Jesus.
Ufike kuseni sebethi maqedile ngawe ebusuku.
Jesus.
Afike kuseni ezokupha amandla amasha. Fika kuseni.
Jesus, fika kuseni.
Oh,
sebethi maqedile ngawe ebusuku.
Kodwa fika
kuseni.
Shaken up a knee,
but you
will never necessarily. No more as if I am Lilu.